On to the main event at Forest Street Stadium, where a crowd of approximately 20,000 spectators packed in ahead of the biggest schoolboy rugby derby in the world.
Ek het in 2011 eerste span gespeel en vandag speel my broer ook eerste span. So vir gym, so ek is baie opgewonde.
Jy kry jou ou pelle hier. Die vibe hier so is so geweldig. Jy kan maar sien hoeveel mense is hier. Waar jy in jou lewe in 'n by 'n skoolwedstryd so baie mense gesien. En dis die ding.
Jy het dit of jy het dit nie. Jy weet. En ek het dit. En boys I het dit. Verstaan? Ek is hier al van 6:00 vanoggend. Ek maak die paviljoen op. Jy weet die vibe in die dorp is lekker. Die skoolgees is lekker.
The elaborate opening ceremony has it all. Parachutes, a flyover, balloons, dancers, a drumline, you name it, it was happening. The bands were pumped up and the vibrant crowd were entertained by the singing of both schools. Finally, it was time for the main event of the weekend. Boys High dominated the play, holding the majority of territory and possession, but handling errors and ill-discipline cost them dearly. Khim, on the other hand, capitalized on all their scoring opportunities, taking an early 9-0 lead, courtesy of three Grant Arbana's penalties. The fullback then added a 5-pointer to his tally when he danced past two Boys High defenders to score a superb try. Soon after, center JD Dodoy went over in the corner and another Hermanas penalty gave Boys High a 24-0 lead at halftime. Desperate for points, Boys High turned down several kickable penalties by opting to run them, and the gamble paid off when Charles-Francois Dodoy crossed the whitewash in the 40th minute. But his score was cancelled almost immediately when Wyatt Murphy looped around Hermanas to score a clinical set-piece try. Nippy Boys High winger Farrell Fass brought his side back into it with a clinical finish to score on the left before elusive fullback Dante van der Merwe danced his way through the defence to score. Fass scored his second 7 minutes from time, which gave the Boys High supporters the belief of a miraculous comeback. But alas, it was not to be, as the clinical Khim team closed the match out to secure a 37-26 win. Referee Jonathan Kaplan's final whistle was met with absolute pandemonium as the Khimi supporters rushed onto the field. Players on both teams were held high on the shoulders of their proud old boys and carried from the field before both sides gave vigorous renditions of their school songs. Khim will rule in Paarl for another year, but Boys High will be back hungrier than ever next year. One thing you can always be sure of at Interskwala is an epic encounter between these two leading SAE rugby schools. We'll see you again in the first week of August 2014 for the next huge Paarl Interskwala.